give thanks for this beautiful gift of life today, dear Creator. Creator, we pray for all the wonderful, beautiful elders, our youth, and our adults, and our children that are present here today to represent and to lead at the Green Party, and all of the wonderful guests and dignitaries that are here today. Creator, we pray for all of our families, all of our elders, all of our youth and children and the unborn. Creator, we ask that all their basic needs and then some will be met today, dear Creator, that their tummies will be full today, and that they'll have a safe place to be tonight, dear Creator. Creator, we pray for all the leaders of the world. We ask that you'll take away all of their greed and their misunderstandings about Mother Earth and about all humanity, dear Creator. We pray that they'll open up their hearts and their minds to restore all humanity and Mother Earth and the universe, dear Creator. We pray for clean air. We pray for good drinking water. We pray for Mother Earth to be able to replenish the food, all of the plants and the vegetables, so that our animals and our fish life may continue to be able to grow and to thrive, that continue to nourish us, our hearts, our bodies, our minds, and our souls each and every day, dear Creator. Creator, we pray for ourselves. We ask that you will continue to embrace us with love and compassion and empathy. We pray that for ourselves, for our brothers and our sisters, our mothers and our fathers, our cousins, our nieces, our nephews, our children, our grandchildren, our great-grandchildren. We ask that, Creator, you will continue to share your knowledge and your understanding and your wisdom with us, so that Mother Earth can be here long after we're gone for our great-grandchildren and our great-great-great-great-grandchildren, dear Creator. Coming from Jack's Point, announcing that they're coming in peace. And that is why it is the welcome song, in which also we welcome each and everyone here today. Also, the elders' prayer song that we shared came from our elders, our traditional elders from Snuneymuxw First Nations. And the song represented that when contact came, when the Europeans came, they took away our drums and our songs and our longhouse and our traditional ways of being. And our elders used to sing the elders' prayer song on a Saturday because they knew they were going to church on Sunday, which was very, very valuable because they were able to keep a part of their drumming and their singing and their traditional ways of praying to the Creator. And now I'm going to introduce my sister Salatia to share about the next song.
It's really great to be here and to honor. Thank you. Yes, we're going to be doing the Chief Dan George from the Burrard Nation over in North Vancouver area. We have, this is a song that's the national anthem of Canada, and it's pretty well sung all over North America, I mean Canada. And it's a great honor to be able to be allowed and be privileged to share this song. This song is clearing the path. Oh.
Organized and run and been stalwart Greens well before I even took out a membership, because I was working in the environmental movement with a firm commitment to remaining nonpartisan. I didn't even join the Green Party until 2006, and that was only because, as I say, I was horrified to discover that someone had become Prime Minister who was against climate action. And I was horrified to realize someone had become Prime Minister with a minority of the vote in a perverse voting system where the other parties who knew better decided it was more important to keep fighting each other than to work together to save Canada from Stephen Harper's serial acts of vandalism as Prime Minister. I don't dislike Stephen Harper, it's not personal. But I have watched since 2006, and he took apart, back in 2006, he destroyed the Law Reform Commission. He took away from the status of Women Canada the mandate to work for equality of women. Good. Step after step, year after year, the changes to the Navigable Waters Protection Act, even before he got to a majority. And then, the false majority of 2011, where we have seen omnibus budget bill after omnibus budget bill, plowing through democracy and leaving behind a wreckage of the laws that once protected us. Good. We've lost the Environmental Assessment Act, lost Good. Protection of fisheries habitat. We've lost what was respected since the early 1970s. Remember? We had a federal, provincial moratorium against super tankers. Stephen Harper just said it didn't exist. It doesn't matter. The priority of putting all our eggs in the bitumen basket hasn't worked so well for the economy either. And this is where, as Greens, as we're going forward in this election campaign, we are bringing a message of hope. Hope for a country that we love. Because we know that is, however often Stephen Harper wants to describe Canada as a warrior nation, we know it's not true. However often he wants to say that the future of Canada lies in rip and strip resource extraction and export, we know that's not true. However often he says that only, and he actually doesn't say this, they've put it into practice as policy, our health accord that's been left abandoned and not renegotiated, but Canada's support federally for provincial health care under Stephen Harper is now going to be tied to the GDP of the provinces. I don't know how many of you know this. So if a province has an economic downturn, it gets less money for healthcare. This is a time bomb ready to go off to hurt Canada's healthcare after Harper is gone. We have to rebuild all the things that he damaged. We have to put things back in the right order, in the way that they have been for Canadians for generations. And that means we have to confront the reality, which goodness knows Brenda Sayers so bravely did for 2.5 years fighting the Canada-China Investment Treaty. We have to face the reality that that is a deal that Houdini can get out of. We have to ask Beijing if they're willing to renegotiate it. We have to make sure that Tom Mulcair and Justin Trudeau understand that that treaty will bind us, and we need brave people who are prepared to say to Canada, we're not going to be looking over our shoulder to find out if Beijing is going to allow us to bring back our laws. We will bring back our laws, and if required to do it, we'll write a check to Beijing, but we will not surrender our sovereignty. By one of the legal experts that Brenda and I relied on for this fight. His name is Gus Van Harten. The book is Sold Down the Yangtze, How Stephen Harper Sold Out Our Sovereignty to the People's Republic of China. We need to make sure that this is one of those election issues that we confront, because we need pragmatic, clear-headed, clear-eyed policies that say, together, Canadians can do anything. Together, we can move away from fossil fuels and embrace new jobs created through renewable energy now, through clean technology, through all those things that create jobs for our kids, because it's unacceptable that the unemployment rate for youth is twice that of the national average. It's 14% unemployment for our youth. That's not acceptable. We know there's work that needs to be done. We have infrastructure that needs building and repairing, whether it's waterworks in our cities, our mass public transit, it's fixing our bridges and fixing our parks. There's work to be done in this country. Canadians know how to do work. We will do it together. So, the one thing that Greens can offer that no other party can, and you've heard it in different ways and in different words from my friends who've been up on stage here before me. We are committed to democracy in its truest sense. If you want to find a job description for what it is to be a member of parliament, there's only one law in Canada that describes the job description of a member of parliament, and it's our constitution. The constitution, by the way, does not mention the existence of political parties. They're not an essential part of democracy. As a matter of fact, I think our democracy would be healthier if we'd never invented political parties. But as leader of one of them, Petra Kelly, who founded the German Green Party, used to describe the German Greens as the anti-party party. I knew I loved it then. But the goal of Greens is to live up to what the job description is in the Constitution, which is members of Parliament represent their constituencies. So every single Green Party member of Parliament does not report to me. As you've heard before today, every Green Party member of Parliament, Paul Manley for Nanaimo, Ladysmith, will work for and report to the people of Nanaimo, Ladysmith. And Fran Hunt-Genucci will work for and report to the people of Cowichan and Malahat, Langford, and Francis Litton will work for the people of Esquimalt, Saanich Sioux. Glenn Sollett will work for the people of Courtney, Alberti, Joanne Roberts will work for the people of Victoria, Ken will work for the people of West Vancouver, Sunshine Coast, Sea to Sky Country, just as I report to the people of Saanich Gulf Islands, who did me the enormous honor and took a risk and decided that it was worth trying to do something that everybody had said was impossible. Don't be fooled by people who say to you, and you will hear this, don't be ridiculous. The Greens only got, what, X percent, 10% in the last election, so how can they possibly take this seat? Remember the figure for Andrew Weaver? 8% in the previous election, 40% when he won. In my riding, 10%, and our vote, the green vote actually, and I had a lot of people explaining this to me patiently as if I didn't know, that the green vote had gone down in 2008 versus 2006. Well, of course it did, because a former green was recruited by the Liberals, her name was Bryony Penn, and a lot of people decided she was the best chance of getting rid of Gary Lunn, who was the minister in Harper's cabinet, and I was running against him, and people would say to me very patiently, you can't possibly win, you know, because look, the green vote went down in 2008, and you can't possibly hope to go from 10% to actually winning. I went from 10%, the vote, the voters, not me, the voters of Saanich Gulf Islands decided to vote green in large numbers. It was the highest voter turnout in Canada, except for PEI, 75% voter turnout in Saanich Gulf Islands, and with 75% voter turnout, 46% voted green. Believe me, we can't be too, I know there are a lot of Saanich Gulf Island volunteers here today in the park. We're going to need everybody to work hard, because some people may think, well, she's been in now for a while, so we can just take it for granted she'll get reelected. Nothing can be taken for granted, ever. But I do know that on May 2nd, 2011, we won convincingly. We had 7,000 more votes than the second place finisher, Gary Lunn. And that's because people were prepared to believe that I offered them something real, honest, and different. I never made a promise I couldn't keep. I promised the voters of Saanich Gulf Islands I would never heckle. I've never heckled. I promised the voters of Saanich Gulf Islands I would work hard for them and work for them when they had problems with government, and I have solved, and my team has solved, literally hundreds of problems that our constituents had dealing with levels of government. I promised that I would introduce a private member's bill to deal with the ongoing tragedy in this country of Lyme disease. And I introduced that bill, and it is now law. I never make a promise I can't keep. And I promise every single one of the brilliant, exemplary, excellent candidates who put their lives on hold, who've decided to do something so brave, things that they never thought they were about to do, who've decided to run to join me in Parliament, along with Greens who are going to get elected across this country. We now have Green representation in the legislatures of Prince Edward Island and New Brunswick and British Columbia, and we will be electing Greens from coast to coast to coast in this election. There's now two Green MPs. I should mention my deputy leader, Bruce Heyer, representing Thunder Bay Superior North. And I've always said, what I yearn for in Parliament is a large and unruly caucus. Greens with opinions, Greens with principle, Greens who get together and say, my riding wants to make sure, and we are going to work so hard to deliver for Canadians what Canadians deserve. Our first documentation of existence way back when it was first the British North America Act talked about, it sounds kind of stodgy, but I love it, peace, order, and good government. I promise you that Greens will work to deliver the finest parliamentarians that you have ever seen, who read every bill, study what we're voting on, make decisions based on evidence, liberate our scientists, take the gags off, fund our scientists, and revive healthy democracy in which Canadians decide, I can't wait to vote. Because I know when I vote, I'm going to get the Canada I love. I'm going to get my country back. I'm going to take my country back, and I'm going to defend it. All the Green Party candidates here today to come up stage with me. Because together we are stronger. I'm so honored to work with these people. My sister,
works for you together. Ready? We are going to be, should we say it together? A Canada that works!
And I'd like to hear you all say, together. So when we say a Canada that works,
you say,
okay, a Canada that works.
Yeah!
A Canada that works.
Yeah!
A Canada that works.
Yeah!
All right, together we are going to elect Green MPs across Vancouver Island and British Columbia.
And Ontario and Quebec and the Maritimes. We are going to be the force for cooperation. We're going to be working across party lines with friends and allies. And that means Stephen Harper will be packing his bags and leaving 24 Sussex Drive.